Let me just start off by saying I loved WandaVision. You could go back on the channel and see my praise and adulation, my continuing call for them to win as many awards as possible. I think it is a brilliant show, a perfect show. I know people didn't like the ending. That's just because of the ridiculous theories that were going around. So I just want to make sure everybody knows that. I love Wanda as the lead character, how powerful she was, her grief, her sorrow, what we all experienced with her story was amazing, the way Marvel Studios put that together. But this episode, I am going to focus on the reason why you clicked and will probably call me every name under the sun. So just like the title says, Wanda is the villain of WandaVision, not Agatha. And Agatha is actually the hero in this story. Now, I'm not really focusing on Agatha. I will towards the end of my theory or observation. So let me just get right on to proving my point. But before I do getting to my point, if you enjoy the content, subscribe to the channel, smash that like button. I will greatly appreciate it. So now, let me get you guys upset. So I'm gonna go with the magic part here, because there's a magic part in an actual real life scenario where she shows us she's the villain of WandaVision, even though it is her show. And again, it was a beautiful story that we were privileged to all enjoying. So we're gonna go, like I said, with the magic part of it. So before I get into the actual reasons, I'm gonna take us to another movie where we found out at least a little bit of why it's wrong to manipulate magic. So in Doctor Strange, Wong warns Doctor Strange when he's learning or puts back the pages of the book of Cogliostro. I'm sure I butchered that. And he tells him a very stern warning. He says, your curiosity could have killed you. You weren't manipulating space-time. You were breaking it. We don't tamper with the natural law. We defend it. So I know that warning was for Doctor Strange when he was manipulating that apple and moving back back and forth from the apple being eaten and the apple not being eaten or bringing it back to a full state. Now at the end of WandaVision, we see Wanda with the Darkhold, the Book of the Damned, however you want to see it. She has this book where she has no understanding of that warning. The amount of rules and regulations that we saw Stephen Strange go through in his knowledge building upon this new source of mystery and magic that he was being introduced by the Ancient One, none of that was told to Wanda. So when we see, and this goes with a lot of theories that are going out, and this is not to focus on where those theories are going out, but it's an innocent scene, right? And we get caught up because we hear Billy's or her kids calling out from wherever they're calling out from, and it looks like she's going to go find them, and we just get stuck on that moment. But let's look at that moment for what it is. She is breaking reality. She is breaking that rule that Wong warned Doctor Strange about. So right then and there, and let me just get this out of the way for both parts. Ignorance is not an excuse. Her not knowing what she was doing in any of the scenarios that I am gonna lay forth from moving forward is no excuse for what she did. She's guilty of this, period, point blank, nothing more to say. So she's breaking that rule. She's manipulating space-time. She's looking at what some are saying other dimensions. With that being said, I think that in the Loki show, going on to a different show that's coming in the near future to Disney Plus. Shameless plug, I guess, even though they're not sponsoring this video. In Loki, we see the Time Variance Authority, and their sole purpose is to monitor the timeline in whatever timeline, in many timelines, however you want to see it. That is their purpose. There's videos I made about Deadpool, about Captain America, and how they can be targets for the Time Variance Authority as fulfilling that plot that they have. But when you watch that WandaVision ending, what she's doing, how, if she is looking at alternate dimensions, and as she's looking at it, for us the viewer, we're just so caught up in that love story and what we saw that we're like, oh, look, she's just trying to find her kid. But she's breaking the golden rule to not mess with the space-time continuity, and she's doing it again with no experience. And even when she tells Monica, I'm going to learn this, she might, and she's doing it by herself, but in that she has no other knowledge, no basic knowledge to know that what she's doing is wrong. So I think the Time Variance might actually be looking, or Wanda's a good candidate for why the TVA is involved in the Loki miniseries moving forward. So the first thing off bat is that she uses, besides that ending point, which is one of her sins as far as proving that she's the villain, even though, again, ignorance is not an excuse, even though I grant it to everyone that Wanda doesn't know what she's doing in any of these events, but that's not the point. The point is that she's doing these events. So in the magic side, she uses magic to create a false reality. The whole thing with Westview, she uses her magic, whether it be from grief, whether it be from her pain, whatever it is, it doesn't matter. She created that. That's a huge red flag as far as that she shouldn't be doing, and it's a huge indication to us the viewer. Of course, after a few episodes, we're not told that right away, only towards the end that she's a villain, a clear indication that she is a villain. Again, ignorance is not an excuse. Two, she kidnaps children and grown people of Westview using her magic. They can't go anywhere. They can't do anything. Even when we see in the Halloween episode on the outside of the city, she is still in control. And you see that lady crying because she can't even break from doing anything. She's just moving the hanger up and down, you know, hanging the clothes, and you could see what kind of pain she's in. And then in the last episode of WandaVision, they tell her about how when they fall asleep, they feel her pain, they have her dreams, they're suffering. You know, three, she makes everyone in town do things against their will. The first three episodes with the changing of the sitcoms, they just call it the first four episodes, the 1950s, 1960s, 1970s, and the 80s, all the ones that are based off the sitcoms. She is forcing them to dress a certain way, act a certain way, do certain things. She is literally manipulating every aspect of their life. Four, she creates her children. She's using magic that she doesn't know, and she becomes pregnant with her two twin boys that might actually jump over from magic into the real world. All of that stuff is the definition. You could put Magneto or any other villain you want in that Doom. The list goes on and on of villains that have done exactly that, whether it be in movies or in the actual comics. That is the definition of being a villain. Now, I could go more into the magic, but I think those, just with the last scene also, how she's moving through or reading the Darkhold and experiencing and practicing actual dark magic. Not Asgardian magic, not, she's doing dark magic from the dark dimension. And that's at least what I'm assuming is the dark dimension. Basically from hell. I don't know how much clearer the show could have told us and made Wanda the villain of WandaVision. So That just on that, on the magic, I could end it and say, hey, you know what? Let me know your thoughts in the comments and end the video. But I wanna make sure I hammer this home to make sure that the illusion, yes, it's a great story, but Wanda is the villain in her own story. Now, we are now, well, one episode into the Falcon and the Winter Soldier. Now, in Civil War, we understand that Team America or Team Captain America become fugitives and go on the run. Then we see them come back and fight for humanity and for the universe in Infinity War and in Endgame. And we just found out in The Falcon and the Winter Soldier that Bucky, that was in Team Captain America, that some of those characters, I mean, I'm assuming Ant-Man, and I'm assuming, you know, Bucky, I'm assuming that everyone that was on Team Captain America got a pardon, because that's what we're told, that Bucky is a free man because he was forgiven. He was given a pardon, and we're going to get to see how he's going to make amends for the events, the crimes that he committed, but yet the universe and the world is grateful that they gave Bucky this second chance to be right. He has to check in. He has to make sure that he doesn't break any laws. I mean, watch the TV show and you'll hear that part where Bucky's talking to his psychiatrist. So I must assume that was also extended to all of them, including Wanda, that was on Team Captain America. So what she did, just with the magic part, she's violating each one that pardon that Bucky got, that I'm assuming everyone got, including Falcon. That pardon, Wanda broke it just with the magic part. But we're gonna go into how she actually broke the pardon that was given to her, and even more of an emphasis as to why she's the villain. So number one, this is just real life proof that she is the villain. Kidnapping. She kidnapped the whole town. Not, that can't be negated. Two, false imprisonment. We find out, again, they can't leave. They can't go out of the hex. Towards the end, one of the townspeople begs her and says, let me hold my daughter. Let her come out of the room. That's false imprisonment on top of child kidnapping, which I have number three. Number four, torture. She's mentally torturing them. Physically making them do things that they don't want to do using the magic, but just in real world consequences, that's torture. Five, she's impeding an investigation or obstruction of justice, if you will, when she does the hex, even though we find out that Hayward is a POS, that doesn't matter. There's an investigation as to what's going on, and she refuses to let any FBI, CIA, local police department, and she even controls some of the police department. Number six, retaliation against a federal officer. I agree with you. Hayward is a POS. I get it. No one likes him. But when she had the guns, she controlled the FBI agents, you know, sword, and they turned the weapons to him and pointed. That's a criminal offense, a federal, a felony, whatever you want to call it. You're a terrorist at that point. Number seven, coercion. She coerced everyone to do exactly what she said, and she threatened physical punishment to the townspeople if they didn't act right. Number eight, at the end, when all of this is done, she flies away like nothing's happening. That is called evading arrest. Now, I did the math to what some of these charges will go. Two of them, 40 years, just the kidnapping alone, up to 20 years, probably even more if you could convince a jury. The false imprisonment, 3 to 7 years. The torture, from any amount, and lifetimes. Impeding an investigation, 10 to 20 years. Evading arrest, 5 to 40 years. And that's the other one, again, so you get the point, and that's per person. So she would be in jail for lifetimes. I'm talking about 500 years. And we see them give those kind of judgments to people in the real life. And I get she's a witch and she might be able to live for thousands of years. You could cast a punishment to be able to cover that gap. And the fact that she runs and goes off and hides into her little cabin, that's exactly what criminals do. Now I'm gonna bring in another universe here, the DCU. But when Superman gets accused of doing all this stuff, and I think in Batman v Superman, he shows up to Congress. He says, no, I'm not running. I'm on the side of justice. I'm in the side of what's right. And he shows up. That's what Captain America kind of was, even though I made a video saying how he truly is a villain. But that's what Captain America is supposed to stand for. To stand for what's right, what's just, even though all of his actions throughout the MCU are very suspect. But like Superman, he steps up to the plate and he shows up and says, no, that's only evil people run. People go and hide. What she did was what Thanos did. Go off into a hub somewhere and ponder and sipping tea like nothing happened. She knew that the town people were going to turn her. The conversation that Monica and her had at the end when Monica goes, oh, they'll never understand what you gave up. What? Of course they wouldn't. Would you understand if someone controlled you like that, controlled your life, didn't let you see your kid, kidnapped you, basically made you do things against your will? And all I see is people making excuses. And I get it, the show was amazing, but she was the villain in this whole WandaVision. And Agatha was the hero when she says that she felt the energy and she wanted to know the source of that energy. She wanted to figure out what was going on. Why is this girl that I've never met, this witch, as she calls her, hey sister, how did you do it? She doesn't know that she is the Scarlet Witch, that she is this mythological creature, or this myth in the book of the Darkhold that's saying that will cause damn and destruction. Until she finally knows that when she takes her back in that the episode, when we have a flashback into all of her events from the moment Tony Stark bomb killed her family to the events in Civil War, or when she's like falling in love with Vision, to when she goes to Vision, when she gets the power of the Mind Stone, when she gets the power, then finally Agatha realizes, yo, this woman is the myth. And I need to use my magic to take this magic that this girl doesn't know what she's done and led me here because I felt this surge of energy. And I know everyone's gonna be like, yeah, well, you know, Doctor Strange should have felt that too. And you're right, he should have felt it. Where was he at? No one knows. But Agatha steps up to the plate, goes to Westview, finds out that Wanda is the Scarlet Witch, goes and fights her with the powers that she grabbed. Obviously, everybody's gonna be like, oh, but her covenant was trying to kill her. They were drawing a parallel the same way, like Wanda didn't know back then what the powers that she was learning. And it took, again, like I said earlier, it's no excuse, but that was the misdirect that the MCU or the show was letting us know. But it was more drawing a parallel of how they could probably understand each other. But Agatha knew that I have to take these powers away. And even I've heard people say, oh, but you know, when she told her that she could keep, and Agatha gives Wanda like a deal, says, hey, just give me your powers and I'll let you have this little world that you created. And they were like, oh, but Agatha's the true villain because she even told Wanda that she was gonna back out on that promise. No, she's literally telling us right there that she is not gonna honor that she's gonna free the townspeople. And we see a little bit when she says, before that conversation goes about the deal, or actually I think the deal was beforehand when she had her kids like in that stranglehold, where they come up with that deal. But even in the town square where she starts, like, as she calls it, cutting the strings of Wanda's meat puppets, she's right there showing us what she's doing. So when they're fighting and she tells her and she's gonna back off of the deal, That's her basically saying, no, I'm not gonna let you keep with Vision. I'm not gonna let you keep your kids that you made through this dark magic. They will go away. I will destroy them, and I'm going to lift this hex, and I'm going to release these town people. That is what a heroes do. That's what a hero does. At taking a wording from Thor, you know, that's what heroes do. That's exactly what Agatha did. And people say, oh, Agatha, you know, was pointing and caused Wanda to do all these things. You know what? Even if I gave you that, Tony Stark did the same thing when he was in the helicarrier poking at Banner and saying, you know, I want to see where you are. That, you know, sometimes heroes, that's the way you got to get your information. You got to ask questions. You got to push the envelope. And that's what Agatha was trying to do, because she didn't know whether Wanda was the myth turned real. And I can't believe a lot of people have such a hard time understanding that. But that's why Wanda is the villain in WandaVision and Agatha is the hero. And even to further further put that period at the end of the sentence, to be able to cross every T and dot every I, what Wanda does to Agatha at the end is even more proof of how evil, how much of a villain, I should say, Wanda is. When she just, I'm gonna put you in the role you chose for yourself, the nosy neighbor, and bam, just leaves her there, like, you know, trapped in that body. Even though I have my suspicions whether Agatha really didn't know and was just playing along, because when we see a shot of her turn around, Agatha's gone. There is no more body there. So maybe that was something with the editing, and they didn't realize that they messed up. But I run under the assumption that there is no coincidences in Marvel. So I hope I proved my case. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. I can't wait to read them, to hear them. And like always, that's a wrap.